I do like my coffee. So lovely to see you back here at the channel. I am Klaus, and in today's episode, we're going to do something a little bit different than usually. This video is made specifically for people who are new to Davinci Resolve or new to Fusion inside of Davinci Resolve or want to start using Fusion instead of layer-based system like After Effects or other ones. After Effects is the most known one. So if you want to start to use Davinci Resolve as your main work thing where you do not have to shift in between applications and you want to understand Fusion a little bit better, but when you open up Fusion, you get the urge to move away, close down Fusion and go back to After Effects because this is a node-based system and not a layer-based system. So I'll try to explain the difference very simple. And again, this is kind of a beginner's tutorial, so nothing too special about it. So, but I do promise you that when you have watched this tutorial, you'll understand the basic of how to set up a project in Fusion and you'll be able to do it in no time by yourself. So without further ado, let's go into Fusion and Davinci Resolve 16. Let's go.
So here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and just to make you understand the basic of this layer system, I'm going to use the editor inside of DaVinci Resolve 16. So what I have here is I have a solid color, which is a white background layer. Then I have on my video 2 track, I have a cow. And then I have on my video 3 track, a triangle or a light beam. And then on the top video layer, I have a UFO. So if we were to make some kind of a quick animation out of this, we'll go to take the top layer, go to the inspector, and then I would, what I did before, I did do something with the sizing and stuff like that. But so let's do something super quick here. Okay, let's just say we want it to be like 2 seconds in, we want this to be our position, and then we'll go back to the beginning here. And then we want our position to be out of the frame. So it'll go in, be there for like very short amount of time. Then we'll hit the keyframe again, and then we'll just go a little further, and then we want it to be out of our frame. So this is now our animation. Then we want our beam to come in, so I'll just quickly do something like that. Okay, and then we want our cow to disappear, so we'll just drag that in like something like this. So now we have a animation going like this. Okay. And that's all easier to understand because it's layer-based. So if we were to do the same thing in Fusion, how would that actually be? So first off, what we need to do, because we'll build it from the ground, is we need to go to the effects. And into the effects here, we have our Fusion composition. And we're just going to drag that down here. And then we have Fusion composition here. And we'll go into Fusion with that selected. Okay. I'll just turn that away. Then I'll go into the media pool and then I'll drag in my media. And then I have 3 of those. So this is my output. So we need to have a input of course of some sense. So what Fusion needs to actually show anything is we need a background. So let's just take in the background and connect that. And that is a black background. So we'll change the solid color to white and say okay. Now we have a white background. So now we can select the first merge and push one. That'll be a triangle. So I'll just push F2. Okay. And our merge 2, we'll have a look what that is. That is a cow. F2. Cow. And then I guess the last one would be the UFO. I'm just going to name that UFO. So the way this works is, of course, now we need to have a cow in here. So actually, if I change it like this instead, it will be like a layer-based system, so maybe we can understand it a bit easier. And then we can... So this is our background, and this is our output. So what we need to do to actually make this visible is we need to add a merge node. And you can find a merge node right here, so you can drag that in. And if you drag it in and keep it over the line until it turns blue and then just release, it will now attach that. So this will be basically our layer, bottom layer. So if we then are connecting the cow to the screen one, we are going to have a cow. And then we have our merge node. And in our merge node, that'll be like the inspector. So we can make the cow smaller. And we can drag it around and replace it. So let's say we want our cow to be here. Then we also want to have our triangle, which was this one. And then again, we need to add in a merge node. And we do it the same way. We add in a merge. There we have our triangle. Now we need to go into the merge. Boom. Maybe we'll size it up a bit. Put in something like there. And then we'll just add in a new merge node. Okay, now I dragged in two. I'll delete one. So if you have nothing selected or you've dropped it too early, the way you could connect it to this is by pushing down the shift and then drag. And then again, until you see this blue occur, and then we'll just let go. So now we'll take our UFO here and we'll add that into. So now we have a UFO, and then we will just have to change something about the angle. You can also change everything by moving here in the circle or taking it and dragging it up, and that's maybe easier. So let's, size-wise, it's not going to be the same as the other, but the basic concept is there. I think it's a little too big, though. Something like that. Okay, so now we have the basics. So now we need to animate this. And the way we would do that is we would be at the, let's say we have 115 frames. So let's say 30 frames in, we need it to be here. So then we'll just click into keyframe. Then we'll go back to the beginning. We'll drag it out of frame. And now we have the first animation. So it will be here now. And then it will be there for a sec. We'll just give a keyframe again. And then let's say when it's at 70 or something, frame 70, it needs to be out of here. So now we have a basic animation in Fusion. Okay. And then we would like to go in here where we had the... So what we did in the other one was we took the layers and we just made them shorter. And you can do kind of the same here. If we go up to this one, which is the keyframes, and we push this icon, we'll zoom in. And now we have to remember what is what. So we'll just push the middle mouse button and we can drag this out here. So I have my things and I have three merge nodes. So I want the triangle to appear at this point, and that'll be like my merge 2. So I'll go over here and have my merge 2 node, and then I can drag that here. And then let's say we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 frames, and I'll go back here and I'll drag that here. And then we need to go to our cow layer, or in this case, we can do it with the merge 1. So we want the, as soon as this is here, the cow should disappear. So we'll just drag that the other way here, something like that. Okay, so this is basically the same animation. And then if you want to add something, you would add effects in between here. So if we wanted to, for instance, blur out the UFO, we would add in a blur node here. So you can see we could blur out the UFO or the cow if we wanted to. And then we would do it the same way. We would, let's say we wanted to start by being blurred out and we want to use Gaussian blur. We'll put in a keyframe. When it's here, it will be focus. So that's what we have now. So again, you can just add in new effects here in between your media and the merge. You have to add all the things, blurs, color grades, different stuff like that. So this is just a look at how Fusion kind of is like layers, but it uses nodes and it's a little bit different, but maybe you'll understand it like this. And this is just how the composition would look in Fusion if it were done in the right way. So instead of stacking things up on top of each other, you're doing it in front of each other. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.